Belinda presents this unabridged recording of My Life and Other Failed Experiments, Tom Weekly, Book 6, written by Tristan Bancks and read by Stig Weems. Hey, I'm Tom Weekly, and my life is a science experiment gone horribly wrong. Things never quite turn out the way I want them to. But my new motto is never give up, never give in. No matter what life throws at me, whether it's a rock-hard fruitcake or a headbutt in a very bad place, getting attacked by a gang of killer possums, eating a car, or being rejected in public by the woman I love, I'm going to look on the bright side. Wish me luck. I'm going in. Tom. Hostage. Give me all your money or the guinea pig gets it. These are the first words I hear when I arrive home from school. I'm standing in my bedroom doorway. My evil sister, Tanya, is holding Gus, my brand new guinea pig, out the window. Gus has long ginger hair. He paws at the air with his tiny claws. What did you say? I ask.
I said, give me all your money or I drop your guinea pig onto the concrete.
It's at least a 3 metre drop to the path below. I've always known my sister was evil. She once threw a hamburger patty at my head. She's used me as a slave for at least 4 years of my childhood. She made me eat Vegemite off her big toe. But to threaten to take the life of the world's cutest guinea pig? This is a new low. So I say the obvious thing. I don't have any money.
Liar!
She shouts, almost making Gus's black marble eyes pop out of his head.
Put him down!
I demand, dropping my school bag to the floor.
If you say so,
she says, shrugging.
No!
I rush forward.
I thought you said put him down,
she says, all innocent.
Give him to me now,
I demand in a low growl.
Be a good little boy,
she says. Unlock your trap door and give me your money. Then you can have the ranger back. I've warned her not to call Gus a ranger. It's not nice to make fun of people with red hair or guinea pigs. I'm going to the movies with Bella in 15 minutes and I need cash, she says.
So make it snappy.
Gus swings in the breeze, his eyes pleading with me to follow her instructions very, very carefully. But I can't. Listening to Tanya is against my religion. And every hostage movie I've ever seen has taught me one thing. Don't give in to the evil kidnapper's demands. Sweat trickles from my forehead and into my eye. I wipe it. I need time to think. I kneel down and peel back the edge of the rug in the middle of my bedroom floor. I roll it back to reveal my trapdoor, a small square hole in the floor, about a school ruler wide and long. It is secured with a flat gold padlock. I glare up at Tanya. I take one of the keys from the string around my neck. I open the padlock. She and Gus watch closely. I lift the lid. It stops Tanya from seeing what's inside. All my worldly possessions. 4.5 packets of Whiz Fizz. A small tub of premium quality homemade slime. A long cardboard pack of sparklers. A book of horror stories that Mum says I'm too young to read. 100 water bombs. A pre-licked giant lollipop in cling wrap. A small black cash box. The cash box has my birthday money in it. $50 from Nan, $50 from Mum, $80 from kids at my party, and some loose change. My entire fortune. I'm saving for a bike, so there's no way I'm giving Tanya $180. Think of everything I could do with that kind of bankroll. Gus only cost me $5 at the pet shop. I could buy another 36 guinea pigs for $180 and set up a guinea pig farm. I could milk them and start a new hipster craze for guinea pig milk. I could tell everyone that it's a superfood with mysterious healing qualities, and they could extend their lives by putting it in their cappuccinos. I look over the lid into Gus's eyes, and I know that my dreams of being a guinea pig milk billionaire can never be realised. I love Gus. I could buy every guinea pig in the world and I'd never find another one like him. He's smart, sensitive, and loyal. He understands me in a way that only a guinea pig could.
My fingers are getting mighty slippery,
Tanya taunts.
Gus is my friend.
Well, that's embarrassing. He's only half a step up from being a rat.
She's talking about Rinalda, my pet rat who's been missing for 2 months. I fear that Mum may have taken her for a long ride out into the bush. A rat napping. I bought Gus to heal the wound left by Rinalda's sudden and mysterious disappearance.
Gus, I tell her. His name is Gus.
I figure reminding her that he has a name might make her care more.
Pass, did you say?
She asks.
Nice name. It suits him.
I look back down into my trap door. I jingle some coins like I'm counting money.
I have $1.60,
I tell her.
That's a lie.
No, it's not. You can come have a look if you like.
Tanya thinks about it for a moment. To look inside the trapdoor, she'll have to move away from the window. Then I'll tackle her, grab Gus, and throw her out the window.
Nice try, she says. You got tons of cash for your birthday.
I spent it.
On what?
Stuff.
What stuff?
Lollies, I say.
You bought $200 worth of lollies?
It was only $180, I say.
Oh, sorry, because $180 is a reasonable amount of money to spend on lollies.
Give me the money now!
I told you, Gus doesn't want you to lie, Tommy. And my arm's getting real tired.
Gus isn't even struggling now. He's just hanging there, swinging back and forth like a pendulum. He's given up hope. I'm the only one who can save him from the clutches of Tanya, the Death Eater of the guinea pig universe.
Okay, you got me, I say. I have $5.35.
I avoid round numbers, hoping that the randomness of $5.35 will trick her into thinking that's all I have. I mean, how could I come up with a number like that just off the top of my head? Sometimes I amaze myself.
That's it!
She screams.
Okay, I say. Relax.
Sheesh, sensitive.
10 seconds, she says. 10, 9.
She looks serious now. I figure I have 3 options. 1, dive into my trapdoor, scramble beneath the house, drag the rusty slippery dip under the window, and when Tanya drops Gus, he'll go wee and slide to safety.
7, 6.
2, give her a brown paper bag stuffed with Whiz Fizz wrappers and tell her it's cash.
5, 4.
Gus gives me 1 last pitiful stare. 3, tell her that Gus is my piggy bank, that he ate the money to hide it for me and that it's inside him. So if she drops Gus, she'll be throwing away the cash.
3, 2.
Then it hits me. The perfect way out of this predicament.
1,
Tanya announces.
Bye-bye, puss. Nice knowing you.
At the last moment, just as Tanya goes to drop Gus, I grab the edge of the rug and pull hard. Tanya's feet slip out from under her. She screams. Her hip hits the windowsill and she goes flying out. Gus does too. They squeal as they fall. What have I done? I rush to the window. I hear the impact. I close my eyes and squeeze them tight. I don't want to see what's happened. What if Gus fell faster than Tanya and was squished beneath her? What if Tanya fell faster than Gus and I've put an end to my only sister? I'd have to go to jail and wear orange prison overalls for the rest of my life. Orange really isn't my colour. I open one eye and look down. What I see surprises me. Tanya is lying on her back on top of the garbage bins parked on the path. Her head is on the recycling, her hips on the garbage, and her legs are in the open green bin with all the compost and grass clippings. The bin lids are dented, but she's only fallen half of the 3 metres to the path. Her eyes are open. "You're alive!" I say.
"You're dead!"
she says. But I'm more worried about Gus. I can't see him. Did she squish him? Has he run away? Just then, I see one furry paw. Then another, clawing out from beneath a rockmelon skin in the compost bin. It's him! Gus! I shout as his nose comes into view.
Hey, little buddy!
Gus squirms all the way out as Tanya sits up. I think quick, look around and lower my long, dark blue curtain out the window. It hovers just above the bin.
Jump on!
I urge. Gus doesn't need to be told twice. He leaps up, digs his little claws into the bottom of the curtain, and I reel him up. It's like a helicopter rescue at sea. As Gus is pulled to safety, Tanya reaches out and makes one last snatch for him. Gus poops with fear, and the nuggets fall directly into Tanya's open mouth. She squeals and spits, clawing at her tongue.
That's it!
She shrieks, just as the garbage bin lid collapses and she falls in, squelching deep down into the rubbish. The doorbell rings.
That must be Bella,
I say.
I'll let her know you're feeling a bit rubbish.
No!
Tanya calls. I peel Gus's claws off the curtain and cuddle him into my chest. I brush some bits of rock melon out of his fur, close my window, lock it, and secure my trapdoor. Somehow, I've managed to hold on to my money, save my precious guinea pig's life, and do away with my evil sister all in one swift pull of a rug. I click my heels as Gus and I head off into the kitchen for a celebratory snack. Hostage situations sure make you hungry. Tom Weekly's must-hear list of weird stuff about guinea pigs. I love facts. Weird facts, funny facts, gross facts. They reckon truth is stranger than fiction. You'll believe that after you listen to my list of freaky guinea pig factoids. Guinea pigs are not related to pigs at all. But female guinea pigs are known as sows and males are boars. The babies are not guinea piglets, though. They're pups. And in the wild, they used to travel in herds. I've seen a video of a guinea pig stampede. Terrifying. Guinea pigs are actually related to capybaras, which are the largest living rodents. Capybaras can grow up to 1.3 metres long and 60 centimetres tall. Let's hope they don't get any ideas about world domination. One of my greatest fears is being eaten alive by an extra-large guinea pig. For thousands of years, tribal people in South America have eaten guinea pigs and, in recent years, they've shown up on plates in fancy South American restaurants around the world. My motto is, never eat a guinea pig unless you want a capybara to eat you. Another name for a guinea pig is a cavy. This is short for their scientific name, Cavia porcellus. Porcellus is Latin for little pig. According to Wikipedia, a Star Wars fan site, Porcellus was also the head chef in Jabba's palace on Tatooine in Return of the Jedi. I hope cavy bolognese wasn't on the menu. When a guinea pig is excited, it jumps up and down. This is called popcorning. The Guinness World Record for longest jump by a guinea pig is held by Truffles, a Scottish guinea pig, who leapt 48 centimetres, almost half a metre, on April 6, 2012. And the fastest guinea pig on the planet, Flash, a guinea pig from London who ran 10 metres in 8.81 seconds on the 27th of July 2009. Dare you to train your GP to beat those amazing feats. An ancient civilization in Peru worshipped guinea pigs and often included them in their artwork. I bet you didn't know you had furry royalty living in your hutch. And how about this little known fact? Guinea pigs eat poo pellets directly from their own bottoms, like a candy dispenser. This is normal for a guinea pig and is known as coprophagy. Sometimes they pull this sick trick 200 times a day. When they're feeling ill, they steal and eat poop from other guinea pigs' bottoms too. At least they're recycling, I guess. Sources: petsforhomes.co.uk.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.